In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad, the great Mahdi. He raised the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, left him to continue the work of raising us, the mentally dead, the lost sheep. Now, as we speak, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad is the Mahdi. The great Mahdi gave him that title. And they left a divine warner and a comforter in our midst, who has grown to be the Messiah, the most honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, in those three names. I would like to greet you with the greeting words of peace, of As-Salaam Alaikum, which means peace be unto you. Thank you for joining the Rise Magazine podcast today. Please do remember to like, share, donate, and subscribe to this channel. We greatly appreciate your feedback and your support. As-Salaam Alaikum.
Praise be to Allah. Thank you so much, Sister Bridget. That was our dear Sister Bridget, the Director of Communications for Rise Magazine, located in Portmore, Jamaica. Praise be to Allah. We thank you, Sister Bridget, for that introduction. I first would like to begin in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. I greet all of our wonderful viewers of the Rise Magazine podcast in the greeting words of peace, of As-Salaam Alaikum. As Sister Bridget has said, simply means peace be unto you. We are here today for another great episode of the Rise Magazine podcast. We have some wonderful guests for you all today, and we're going to get right into that. But before doing so, we want to thank our CEO and founder of Rise Magazine, and that is Student Regional Minister Abdul Sharrieff Muhammad, the CEO and founder of Rise Magazine in the Rise Magazine podcast. We thank him for giving us the opportunity to be a part of this platform, to share information, collectively come together, share our talents, pool our resources, and really show what it means to be united in doing the work of God. So once again, we thank our hardworking Student Regional Minister Abdul Sharrieff Muhammad for giving us all this opportunity. So once again, going back to today's episode, as mentioned, we have a great episode in store. If we can put up the flyer that we have to introduce that topic that we have for everyone today. Praise be to Allah. So it's the Rise Magazine podcast. The topic is Rising Amidst Resistance, a discussion on Black media, unity, and the making of history. Now, our two special guests, and we're going to bring them on, but we have Student Minister Sister Zurifah Muhammad and Student Minister Brother Ilia Rashad, who will be sharing some great information with us all today. We look forward to hearing from them. Before doing that, we also want to let everyone know, please show your support for Rise Magazine. You can go to www.risemagazineco.com to show your support. Once again, that is www.risemagazineco.com. It is on the screen. You can get information about all things Rise Magazine. Visit our social media page as well. See how you can take out an advertisement if you have a business. All present on the Rise Magazine website. Also, if you would like to assist us in what we're doing as well, so if you like graphic design, if you like writing, you can assist us. Just go on our website. You'll see a form that you can fill out, and you can help us on the Rise Magazine staff. That would be greatly appreciated. We also want to say that to show your support, you can donate to our Cash App. If we can put our Cash App at the bottom of the screen, and that is $RiseMagazine. So please support us so that we can keep this going. Once again, the Cash App is $RiseMagazine. Another thing we're going to mention before getting into our discussion today is that this episode of the Rise Magazine podcast is sponsored by Your Bean Pie. If we can also put that up, praise be to Allah, we have the best tech team on the Rise Magazine podcast. And so this is Your Bean Pie. You can order, you can give us a call at 404-963-1078. Once again, that's 404-963-1078. And you can visit us in person at 3638 Campbellton Road Southwest. That's Atlanta, Georgia. Once again, that's 3638 Campbellton Road Southwest. That's Atlanta, Georgia. The number is on the screen. You can get a delicious slice of Your Bean Pie. You can get a mini pie, or you can get a whole pie that's shown on the screen. You definitely won't regret it. You might regret eating a little too much, but that's okay. Definitely want to make sure that you get your bean pie. And also, we have to mention, we're in the month of Ramadan as Muslims. And so for everyone who is watching, we want to wish you Ramadan Mubarak, a peaceful Ramadan, a happy Ramadan to everyone who's watching. And we have the beautiful picture on the screen once again, wishing everyone Ramadan Mubarak. All right, at this time, we're going to bring on our co-host for an introduction. And then following that, we're going to bring on our wonderful guest. So we're going to start with Sister Bridget for an introduction, and then we'll go down to our dear sister, Sister Farah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. As-Salaam Alaikum and Ramadan Mubarak. I am Sister Bridget X from the island of Jamaica, and I'm the Director of Communications for the Caribbean. Also a writer, for Rise Magazine. And co-host. Thank you.
Praise be to Allah. Thank you, Sister Bridget.
As-Salaam Alaikum, family, and Ramadan Mubarak to all our guests and viewers. My name is Brother Mikhail Yusuf Muhammad, coming to you from the island nation of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, where I am the national representative, also Caribbean Special Assistant to the Nation of Islam. As-Salaam Alaikum.
Praise be to Allah. Well, Islam, Brother Mikhail, thank you. Thank you. And lastly, we have our dear sister, Sister Farah.
As-Salaam Alaikum and Ramadan. This is Sister Farah from Florida, and I will be helping with co-hosting today.
Praise be to Allah. All right, so at this time, we're going to go ahead and bring on our wonderful guest. Everyone became acquainted with the co-host. Now let's bring on our guest. Firstly, we'll bring on our dear sister, student minister Zurifah Muhammad, to give a brief introduction about who she is, what exactly she does. Followed by that, we'll go to student minister, Brother Ilia Rashad Muhammad.
Hi, As-Salaam Alaikum and Ramadan Mubarak.
Wa alaikum
salam. To all my family and friends and family of the nation. I am student minister Zurifah Muhammad. I am the study group coordinator in Athens, Georgia, soon to become mosque in Athens, Georgia, if Allah blesses us to say the same. So we're working on that really hard. I am also, I always consider myself one of Brother Minister Sharrieff's assistants, you know, in the nation. We're always striving to help him to help and make the minister's word bond. He is very supportive of us in Athens, and we are looking forward. I cannot even not say it at the beginning because I don't want anybody to miss it. We're looking so forward to Brother Ilia Rashad being in Athens, Georgia, March the 23rd. And I'm looking forward to seeing Brother Sharrieff and the whole family there on March the 23rd to see this beautiful, wonderful premiere for Georgia. But I would be remiss in my duties if I didn't thank Brother Minister for allowing me to have the opportunity to come back on this week. He is always showing his support for all of us in the nation. And I'm especially happy and thankful to Allah God because he shows his support for the women moving forward in the Nation of Islam. Most people think that we're oppressed and walking 10 paces behind our man. It's never been like that for us. And so I like the fact that, and you all can actually see the fact that that's not the case with the editor-in-chief of Rise Magazine being a sister here and the women that's on here. But it's no slight to our powerful brothers because without them, we couldn't do any of this. So thank you, Sister Aziza, for allowing me this opportunity to introduce myself and do like I do, I guess, as a student minister, go on and on. So thank you, ma'am. Praises be to Allah.
Thank you, student minister. This is Zurifah. Beautiful introduction. Now we're going to go to our dear brother, Brother Ilia Rashad. We can't wait to hear from you, sir.
Thank you so much for having me. Again, I'm Brother Ilia Rashad Muhammad. I'm one of the student ministers serving on the Honorable Minister Farrakhan's research staff, which is the Nation of Islam's research staff. And I'm based here in Memphis with our dear brother, that great teacher of Islam, student minister Abdul Muthakir Muhammad, where He has a host of helpers for the Honorable Minister Farrakhan coming up out of Memphis and out of the South, period, apparently. And I'm so anxious, you know, because we've been blessed to have produced this second installment of the Answer documentary series. And I am just amazed at how everything is taking off. You know, we're going to be in Athens shortly where we showcase the premiere of Answered Part 2, The Coming of God. So I'm just excited about that. I'm excited about being on Rise Magazine's podcast, where we're going to share some positive information as we work our way down to Georgia in just a few weeks.
Crazy, Tola. Yes, sir. Wonderful introduction. Thank you so much. Again, Student Minister Sister Zurifah and Student Minister Brother Ilia Rashad for two great introductions. All right, and before we go on to questions and answers, I want to read one of the comments that we have so far, and that's from Brother Louis Muhammad. He said, don't tease me with the bean pie. Crazy cool. So for everyone who's watching, make sure you keep leaving your comments so we can have an interactive conversation. So once again, everyone who's watching, leave your comments below. If you have anything for our guests, make sure that you state it so that we can acknowledge you. All right, so going to the first question, and this could be for either of our guests. Sister Bridget, are you available for the first question?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. So this question is for both our student ministers. What does rising amidst resistance means to you? Thank you.
Brother Minister?
Yes, sir. You can go first.
Yes, ma'am. Rising against resistance. That is pretty much the basis of our struggle here in America as Black folks. That is the basis of our fight in Islam. We say that we are fighting for Islam and we will surely win. Well, there is no way that we can fight for righteousness, fight for Islam, fight for freedom, justice, and equality when we are in a world governed by just the opposite, a world governed by injustice, slavery, suffering, and death. So the very fact of us being Muslims and standing and living on the principles of righteousness for Almighty God Allah, it puts us in direct opposition to the powers and very foundation of this current world's paradigm. So it behooves us as Muslims to be fighters, to be strugglers, to resist against a world of oppression like this. And in fact, we can't consider ourselves Muslims or righteous persons if we're not fighting and struggling against this world and the corruption thereof every day.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
All praises be to Allah. You know, it's kind of hard to come behind Brother Ilia. I might need to go first. You know, I mean, really, it's kind of hard. But, you know,
you're a fighter.
Praises be to, see, rising up in the midst of resistance. Mm-hmm. So praises be to Allah. But, you know, I also think, you know, I ditto what my brother said. And then the fact that we as Black people, period, you know, when you're living in a world where the majority is looked at as being right, but that is the population that's more than likely incorrect or going opposite of God, and you're not being taught or fed the proper knowledge, or if you are somebody's attempting to feed it to you, you're spitting it back up, so you're not getting the nutrients from it because you think that where the way you've been brought up is the right way. When the Quran, you saying that you believe the way your fathers believe. And the Quran said, are you really, it's paraphrasing, are you serious? You know, they didn't get it right. So, you know, it's really difficult. It can be a difficult thing for those if you're not able to open your mind and heart and allow God to talk to you. Because God is talking to each one of us if we're listening.
Yes, ma'am.
So he put it in us at birth before we were born to be able to submit. But sometimes we get so wrapped up in this world and being a part of the world that we forget or we don't accept the truth when we hear it. So, you know, right. as the old people say, make it make sense to you. Mm-hmm. And the Nation of Islam makes sense.
Come on.
And, you know, so you definitely need to listen. And I know you're thinking, oh, everybody thinks that. Well, let's see. Prove us wrong. Why don't you do that? We got a brother here that's on the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan's research team. So we have him here today. You don't think a scientist like that, because that's what he is. You don't think a scientist like that didn't look into what we're being taught? Do you think that he didn't dig in deep with the rest of the researchers?
Go ahead. So
flipped it up, turned it around, spin it over, turned it backside, slapped it on the other side, and looked at it again. Even though they believe, they still did it because the minister said it. So now it's time for them to bring out, go research it, find it, and then prove what I'm saying is correct. So that's what they do every day. So, you know, I mean, that's how we rise, is we have to get knowledge, I think. And I think that that's very important for all of us as Black people. Thank
beautiful. All right, next we have our question from our dear sister, Sister Farah.
Yes, my question is about the documentary. Why do you think, why is this documentary so important in today's time, and what has been the response so far from the youth?
I'll start with the first part. Why is it important? I would go as far as saying that the topic of the documentary is perhaps the most important topic in the world, because the topic that we're covering involves the coming of God. It involves the presence and the power of God, who aims to use that power to save and help us, those who have been most oppressed, most enslaved, most tortured and dehumanized. Mm-hmm. It is super important that we, as Black and oppressed people, know that there is a real power in the world that is greater than the power of our oppressors. And it is just as important for us to know that that power is on our side.
Yes,
so
sir.
If we knew that, if we right. knew that we have some type of backup, then it would behoove us to stand with that power and follow the guidance of that power. So what we have is not only the most important, but truthfully, the most newsworthy topic. And it's not strange, the fact that the youth are the ones who are picking up on this the most. You know, the Nation of Islam has been teaching this truth about so-called UFOs and, or the wheel, as we call it, for over 90 years. And people still hadn't gotten it. But this is a new generation. This is a new age. And we find that our younger people tend to be a little more practical, tend to be a little more logical, even. They're not so much into religion in the traditional sense. You're not going to tell these young, brilliant minds to just believe something just because, you know, the Bible say it, or the Quran say it, or the pastor say it. Oh, no, they're like, well, who is he? So today's mind is in need of powerful information. Yes. Today's mind is in need of wisdom that fulfills their scientific inquiries. And we are blessed to know that the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, as being demonstrated and illustrated to us by the Honorable Minister Farrakhan, fulfills that need. It fulfills the void of religion.
Yes, sir.
It fulfills the void of science. So the youth have been perhaps the most susceptible to what we have to offer in this documentary.
Praise be to Allah. Beautiful. And I do want to say, the one who asked the question, Sister Farah, she is 21 years old. So that just goes in line with the mind of our youth.
Figures.
Praise be to Allah. All right, if we can show that picture of the screening for Brother Ilia Rashad's documentary, we can show it on the screen right now.
Hey.
Praise be to Allah. Look at that. Go ahead.
They even got the picture of me sitting like I'm cool.
Yes, absolutely. Praises be to Allah. Look like a Savior's Day picture.
You know what? That was Savior's Day from a couple of years ago. I remember that.
Yes, sir. Praises be to Allah. Beautiful.
We want to address that. And Sister Farah, she made a correction. She said she just turned 22 earlier this month, actually. So yes, we have praise be to Allah.
All right.
All right.
Praise be to Allah.
So the next question, I actually have a question. We're gonna go on to Brother Mikhail. But if we can keep up that picture that we just had on the screen. Okay, praise be to Allah. So my question for you, Brother Ilia Rashad, is what inspired the graphics of that picture that we're seeing right now? It says Ilia Rashad, a Nation Brothers film, answered, and then it says at the bottom, the coming of God. And then just looking at the illustrations, looking at the wording, I guess that goes back to, you know, working on a publication, noticing things like that. But what inspired you to come up with the wording as you did in the design?
You know, I would honestly say that the wording in terms of the title of this particular episode of the documentary, as well as the flyer, was all very last minute. We literally had the documentary completed and everything, and we didn't have a subtitle for it, nor did we have a cover for this particular installment for part two, as you see here. That came almost in a matter of hours, because as I was reviewing the actual documentary, which this one is like 2 hours and 15 minutes, I was looking at what the content mostly entails. And when I reviewed it, it pretty much got to the root of the coming of God. And that's what it deals with. So we subtitled this episode of Answered as The Coming of God. And now we had to come up with some type of illustration that would suggest and reflect that. And since this documentary series heavily involves answering the truth about the UFO phenomena, which, by the way, only the Nation of Islam can answer it truthfully, we wanted to show how the advent of the modern UFO phenomena is directly connected to God's coming and his presence. So we use the silhouette of a man who seems to be coming from that lofty celestial wheel-like object in the background, as though the man is coming forward to something for a particular purpose. And I think this, we wanted to, in words, capsulize the coming of God in the person of Master Father Muhammad, the God who is responsible for these so-called UFOs, that wheel-like object that is used in divine fulfillment of a machine that God uses to enact judgment. But it also reflects God's coming for his people, because that's the greatest demonstration of his love, the fact that God would come himself. There's a scripture in the Bible that describes this Holy One as taking off his holy robes and would go and put on some dyed garments. This is indicative of the great Mahdi, Master Father Muhammad, who left what you could say a lofty celestial place on that wheel to come for his people to seek and to save that which is lost. So we are the beneficiaries and the recipients of divine favor in the coming of Almighty God Allah, who came for his people. So that's what the documentary entails. That is what the poster we hoped would also reflect.
Beautiful. Yes, sir. Thank you for that response. All right, now we're going to go on to our next question, and that is from our dear brother from St. Vincent, Brother Mikhail.
Yes, ma'am. My first question is to Sister Zurifah. I reflect back to a conversation I had with a dear friend, Minister Ava Muhammad. Mm-hmm. After her experience as a minister in Georgia, I know is there something in the water in Georgia that this is where the women rise to the podium. But I reflect on something she had said, and to go back to the issue of resistance, besides the difficulties of any minister and what it entails, some of the resistance or difficulties is not so much as a woman, but as men having the ability to submit to a woman or being led in a way by a woman. It's our some men's difficulty to do that. So how do you deal with that? How do you deal? Wow. Or do you have to deal with it? And if so, how do you deal with it?
Excellent question. All praises be to Allah. Excellent question. Well, my brother, it's not so much as submitting to the woman. I don't think men really have a problem with that. I think that sometimes our ego gets in the way and we have a problem submitting, period. But as far as the woman, I think it is the post. As a student minister, it is submitting to the post. And the brothers that are in Athens, and brothers around the nation, I strive very hard, as I know Minister Ava did as well. May Allah be pleased with her, to always remain respectful to our brothers and our sisters. And I believe that as striving to be into oneness with Allah, if you approach every situation and every conversation as if you are speaking to the God or the minister or the messenger, there's a different tone when you're talking to them. So, you know, and from what I've read in our books and things, Master Farah Muhammad didn't play. And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad didn't play. They didn't mince a bunch of words and all of that. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan does not play. But he has a side that, you know, where he can, you know, he has a little comedy side to him and, you know, little downside. But you still know that he is the Messiah. You know, you still know that you're dealing with God's man. So you should never, as Brother Sharrieff always says, you should never take liberties with the minister. So if I'm speaking to the minister, I would never take liberties with the minister. So if I don't take liberties with my brothers or my sisters, then they would have to see that I'm striving very hard to reflect what I say I believe in. So in Athens, sometimes you say we get a little superstition. I don't want to say it because it might, well, we don't believe in that. So I'm going to say it. We don't have that problem in Athens. You know, when I first became the student minister there 4 years ago, it was new. But we build a community of love. Our foundation is love. We don't love enough as a people. So we started out with love. If we love enough, then you can get through anything. So you have to build the love and the bond and the relationships so that one day if you wake up and you got a big stick in your eye and you're in pain, you want to be like a bear, then your brother or your sister say, oh, what's going on today? That's not normally you. I'm just, you know, being practical with my answer to you. That's the way it is for us. We strive very hard. And I'm going to tell you, I saw when I spoke to Minister Ava, when I saw her at a minister's meeting that we had a couple of years ago, I said, Minister Ava, I said, I realized through our study in Athens that if we master the study guides, we got it. She said, absolutely. If we master, because the study guides are a guide through the minister's life. And if you understand the study guides, a struggle for balance, overcoming difficulty, you know, the will of building the will. You know, when you understand rising above emotions into the thinking of God,
that's it.
When you can get into the study guides and you look at everything that's stated in that guide to yourself, you're not trying to fix somebody else. You're trying to fix yourself. When you do that, you can get into a sense of peace because you have to submit your will to do the will of God. And my last statement, our national captain said one day, she said, as soon as we submit totally to the will of Allah, we're at peace at once.
Mm. Beautiful, yeah. Beautiful.
So praises be to Allah. I hope that answered the question. Beautiful answer. Praise be to Allah. Thank you so much, Sister, for answering that question. Thank you for asking the question.
Crazy to Allah. All right, let's make sure we're on mute. Okay, so I have another question, and this also is for Sister Student Minister Zurifah, and I'd like to ask her, what prompted yourself and the believers in Athens to have Brother Ilia Rashad in Athens so soon after Phoenix? If you would like to answer that.
Well, all praises be to Allah. Thank you for that question.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to know that question.
Is now located in Athens, who is from Phoenix. Brother Kenny Muhammad, a hardworking brother, is from Phoenix, Arizona. And he was out there in Phoenix, you know, because he still has his business and stuff in Phoenix. And so as a matter of fact, he and his wife just had a new baby. And so he saw the premiere out there and he came back fired up. You know, we need to have Brother Ilia. And I mean, I'm talking about he was so fired up. He wanted to bring Brother Ilia Rashad in 2 weeks. We might need a little bit more time than that. So he was the inspiring force behind us bringing Brother to Athens. And I'm so thankful to Allah that he was, because you know, Athens being a small city, you know, sometimes when you're small, you think, okay, we can't do it. Yes, you can. You can't be a God walking around talking about I can't.
Come on.
Now, I'm going to tell you, before we get started, everybody knows me, and I'm a little bit country, and when I get excited, that wang comes out. So that's it is what it is. But you cannot be a God and be scared or fearful.
That's real.
So when Brother Kenny started talking about it, and I said, well, we need a little more time than the 2 weeks, he gave me this spiel about, you know, no, we can do it. We can do it. He almost had me saying, okay, 2 weeks is enough time, because he was just that fired up about it. So we set another date and we said, we can do this. And I'm proud to say we're actually looking for another spot to either run Brother Ilia like he running a 5,000 mile marathon on that Saturday, starting at a different time. He go here to here, or trying to do something Sunday after the mosque meet in another building. But we're actually looking for an overflow room that will seat at a minimum of 100 people, because we got that many people who procrastinated and didn't get a ticket. So all those who calling me know that's how I am. I just tell the truth. But so we're looking for something to make sure we can accommodate, because I do understand that you all want to see it. And I'm telling you, it is worth it. And I'm going to say this. I don't understand. I want to say this first. We as Black people need to know this film is not sci-fi. So it's real. So don't think that, you know, you're sitting here and you're watching Star Trek or Deep Space Nine or whatever that is. That's not the real deal. This is real.
So go ahead.
That we read the Bible or go past it or go by it or been told about it, and you hear about Ezekiel, you hear about Elijah being picked up by the chariot. What you think? You'd rather believe that horses came out the sky, and I mean literally running horses on a chariot that you can only think about from the old days, as opposed to a modernized, and we're talking about God.
Mm-hmm.
Why would he need to use horses? regular horses. This is what we'd be thinking now. That's why I said make it make sense to yourself. So, I don't understand why we have a difficult factor in believing what we've been taught in the Nation of Islam and what you've heard from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan all these years. You'd rather believe somebody that will kill you just by looking at you if they could, and you believe what they say. So I think we need to start thinking like intelligent people and make it make sense. So if you cannot come out to see the premiere this time, or you didn't get a ticket, or we're not able to accommodate, I'm sure you will be hearing about where brother will be next if it's got to be back in Athens. So stay tuned.
All right.
Thank you, Sister Lisa.
Crazy to a lot. Beautiful. Brother Ilia, any comments on that?
Look, I was so excited for the invite, you know, because it's those small cities that sometimes feel like they're insignificant. And sometimes these type of cities, like in Athens, they need a good boost, you know?
Yes.
And what better way to give them a boost than to come to show and prove who and what God is?
Yes, you know? That's right.
So this film is more than just a film. It is a part of our ministry. It is a tool of the Honorable Minister Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam. And in some respects, you could even consider it somewhat of a weapon of us, of ours.
Yes.
And I say that in the sense that it's a weapon in terms of it's used to defend the teachings, defend the foundation of what we have, to the point where even our staunchest skeptics, you know, you can't be presented with this information and leave the same. So, and it just makes, from all the reports that I heard and feedback from those that have watched it, whether they were already believers or not, one of the common things that I keep hearing is that it just made what I heard and may have believed, it just made it more real, you know, to see the newspaper headlines, to see the reports from what white folks were saying about the Savior. You know, it all makes sense, and it all bears witness to the point that what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the minister teach us is 1,000% correct. So we have a God on our side, and it only makes sense that we get acquainted with that God. So I'm so excited about coming to Athens. And Athens, you know, is no lightweight place. It may seem like a small town, but I don't think it's coincidental that this is the city with one of our great sister student ministers that the nation is coming to see who she is. Now, Sister Zurifah, she came through Memphis a few months ago. Was it this past summer or this past fall? Yes, and she tore it up. Great. So sometimes you have a jewel among you, but you don't know how valuable and precious that jewel is until sometimes you go outside of Athens or outside of the city and you start seeing how other people are responding. You know, you hear Sister Zurifah every Sunday, probably, you know. And yes, she's a loving student minister, but she's a powerhouse now. So to be invited by our family in Athens, man, look, that boosts my spirit. Y'all got me excited.
Praise be to Allah.
Beautiful. Praise be to Allah. All right. So I'm going to read some comments and then we're going to go to a next question from our dear brother, Brother Mikhail. And so we have comments. Kimba wrote, praise be to Allah. Thank you. We have official MNIB. All praises due to Allah. As-Salaam Alaikum. Happy Savior's Day. Plural, no longer singular. And Ramadan Mubarak from Manchester, England, UK. I see you got the flyer. The flyest beekeeper in the nation today. In Rashad, and a bee emoji. Praise be to Allah. And then
bless
we have,
you, dear brother.
Praise be to Allah. Nat Turner, Library Radio, Ramadan Mubarak, the reality of God is the only topic. Praise be to Allah. Thank you for commenting. That is Brother Michael Muhammad. We have Marcus Toussaint Muhammad says, As-Salaam Alaikum, fam. 2-3 M's. Praise be to Allah. So for everyone who's watching, please make sure you keep your comments going and leave your feedback or any questions that you may have for our guests. All right, Brother Mikhail, you can ask your question.
Thank you, ma'am. Brother Ilia Rashad, hopefully you can answer this question I've had for a long time. My first, contact with or interaction with wheel-related phenomenon, I was about 4 years old. So I did not have, what we call a resistance to it. And I never understood. And you had to fight this, right? You're bringing this information, and you have to fight the resistance that people have towards this concept of that there are these crafts that are hovering above us. What makes it so hard for people to actually believe in a way that is strongly disbelieved that they could be there? I've never seen the spacecraft discovery or all that, and I believe they're there, even though I never saw it myself. There's something about these crafts that there's a serious resistance. What would you think?
The root of the, let's say, disbelief or unwillingness to accept the plain truth is the fact that to accept the reality of these planes is that you have to admit that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and Minister Farrakhan are 1,000% right. So that's part of the root of the unwillingness to accept the truth about the UFO phenomena, because the truth about it leads to the Nation of Islam. You're gonna have to bear witness that the Nation of Islam is right and exact. But the other part to that, because it should not be difficult for anyone to believe that human beings can make aircraft that fly in the sky. That's what these wheels or so-called UFOs are. So if you tell me somebody don't believe that, then you could say they belong in some insane asylum. Right. You don't believe human beings can make aircraft. No, there's something else going on there. You don't want to admit that the Nation of Islam is right. But take into consideration what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said in Message to the Black Man. He made it plain that for thousands and thousands of years, people have worshiped their own ideas of God. And because God has been made into some type of spook that doesn't have to make any sense at all, then this justifies in the people who believe in a spook God, it justifies them not having for anything to have to make sense to them. Because if God don't have to make sense, then nothing have to make sense. So right. You can believe any doggone thing that people say. This is why we are so thankful that Allah gave us what he described as the mathematical theology. Mm-hmm. See, you can't be a slave with a mathematical theology, because mm-hmm. with a mathematical theology, it creates and prompts in us a sound scientific mind. It prompts in us a scientific way of thinking that forces us to question spook religion. To question a spook God. I don't care who's presenting it to us, whether it's an Arab Muslim, a white Christian, black Christian. Look, if it don't make sense, it don't make sense. And if it is inconsistent with the way of God, then it just don't make sense. And I'll end with this part right here. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said it, and I'm paraphrasing, I might be quoting it. He said, if your religion is not rooted in the universal order of things, then you have no religion. So if your religion, if your education, if your way of thinking is not rooted in the universal order of things, which is based on order and mathematics and science and rightness, if whatever you believe is not based on that, then look, you're following the wrong God, the wrong religion, the wrong education. So I would encourage you to accept that mathematical theology. And if you accept this mathematical theology, you have no problem whatsoever accepting the fact that God came in the person of Master Father Muhammad because he brought proof of it, i.e. UFOs.
Crazy, Tula. Beautiful. Thank you for that, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Crazy, Tula. I want to read some of the comments that we have. So we have our dear sister Tangela Muhammad. She puts Ramadan Mubarak, As-Salaam Alaikum, all praises due to Allah. She also put, that's right, 3 exclamation points. Crazy, Tula. Once again, everyone who's watching, keep your comments coming. And next, we're going to go on to Sister Bridget with a question.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Brother Minister, would you mind naming a few critics that, you know, question you in regards to your premiere, the good and the bad? Thank you.
Right. You can tell that what we are doing is right and based on the truth, because most critics don't even deal with us. We try to get critics to talk to us and the critics keep running. So it's a heck of a thing when you can't even get your critics to come and, you know, criticize you publicly because they don't want to even bring attention to this subject matter. But because we are students of the Honorable Minister Farrakhan, quite naturally, we do have critics. And they do say things, although they do it from afar. I mean, let's consider even the Anti-Defamation League and the ADL. Did you know that the Anti-Defamation League, in one of their reports, literally categorized UFO research and studies under the banner of anti-Semitism? They put it in the same category as some of the New Age teaching and anything about the Rothschilds. They documented this and this UFO stuff. They put it under the whole banner of anti-Semitism. And the Southern Poverty Law Center, even they noted our book, UFOs and the Nation of Islam, which they described as Minister Farrakhan or the Nation of Islam's book. They called it bizarre teaching. What? It's bizarre? So hundreds of millions of people across our planet have witnessed these disc-shaped, wheel-shaped crafts flying all around, have reported it. Some of them got pictures and videos of it. Hundreds of millions of people around the earth who witnessed exactly what the Nation of Islam has been telling you about. But you call it bizarre. So yes, we do have critics, but they don't amount to anything because they know that they cannot stand, they can't hold a candle to what we're presenting because again, this is based on that mathematical theology. This is what the scriptures refer to as sound doctrine. You don't have to go and have to wander and ponder and even have to meditate. No, you can do some basic research and some thinking. And you can find that this is true. So, yeah, sometimes I kind of wish that the critics would come and talk to me sometimes, you know? I feel kind of lonely. They don't talk to me
no more.
Yes,
sir. Praise be to Allah. Beautiful response. So, Zurifah, you had any comments on that?
Yes, ma'am. You know, every time that there is truth out, when you have an enemy, they don't want you to know the truth. So at some point you have to make up your own mind as to whether you're going to listen to someone who has never done any harm to you and has only been fighting for you and I since the day that they could fight. You know, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad put on Muhammad Speaks about the wheel. I believe the title was Examining Ezekiel's Wheel on one of them. And then analysis. Another one, yep. Analysis. And then the other one was I think the other one was the analysis. No, the battle in the sky in 1973. So but now if you let the Caucasian or others handle it, they will take it for themselves. That's why you see them coming out now, talking about it. Some of them coming out because they want to be the discoverer of something that has been talked about since forever. And so now they want, for 90 years, as brother said earlier, but now today you're Johnny come lately and you want to be the discoverer. You want it to be known as Rothschild's theory or Goldstein's theory. You want it to be something like that. So, you know, just as we've been written out of history many times to the point where they'll only give you 28 days every 4 years, 29, then, you know, so you will be written out of history knowing about the mother plane. See, we didn't call it UFOs.
That's right.
See, it had a name because God told the Honorable Elijah Muhammad what it was. I don't have no problem saying it.
Go ahead.
So we didn't have an unidentified flying object. We had it identified. But you go out in front of the people so that you can make it look like when we tell it, because you're stealing. He didn't stop stealing. You know, went and stole notes. So you already know. So you go out ahead of us. So you can try to make it seem like that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad is the one that needs mocking. But see, God will make you pay for that. It's written for the mockery of his man. You want to say that the minister is making it up. But then everywhere you turn up, see, God will let you know he's there. Our people just need to make it make sense. You know, I think that might be, I'm stuck on that tonight, apparently. It needs to make sense.
Yep.
Yes, because brother is telling us that it's been, well, of course it's been researched, but we already had the knowledge. Now you hear different people bearing witness. You know, yes, we saw UFOs, or yes, we saw this, or we don't know what the big boat in the sky was. You know, you just, they're subject to tell you anything. Anytime somebody will tell you today, let me just be clear, that there is no vaccine for corona. And then tomorrow tell you we got a vaccine. And then the next day tell you it takes 25 years to make a vaccine, but we just heard about corona yesterday. And tell you there is no vaccine, that the vaccine, if you take it now, this is a week later, if you take it, you can't sue me when you die in 20 years. Nobody in your family can sue us ever. Mm. But we're going to give you this shot. Now, we're not going to give it to babies. Okay, now 2 weeks later, now we can give it to your babies. Mm. Anytime somebody tell you that, anytime they'll run that on you, and we have the attention span of a two-year-old. They tell us this today, tomorrow they change it, they double back the next day, we don't remember nothing they say. So why would you listen to them about anything? I mean, really, if they told me that the sky was orange, I wouldn't believe none of that. If they told me that the sky was black, I'd have to investigate, because I'm telling you, they lie every other word. I've never seen an entire people. And what did God do? The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said they lie before ever the truth come out. But what did God do? He let you see an example of what they really think. With Trump, we couldn't see it in no other president. He was the only one bold enough that they didn't even like, because he don't care about what they think either. So what he did was he come out and showed you what over half of the country thinks.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
You look at that now, because Biden didn't win but by a little bit. That ain't counting the people who didn't vote. So if you're looking at it like that, we do have to learn to say, okay, Minister Farrakhan has been nothing but wonderful to us. You know, we have some people who silly enough to look at the minister and say, well, you know, I agree with a lot that Farrakhan say, but you know, some stuff I just can't get with it. Okay, so now where did you get your teaching? We know where he got his. So when you compare the two, you should just sit back and say, let me just sit down and listen. I'm sorry. I get, you know, excited.
That's Sister Minister right there. Praise be to Allah.
Praise be to Allah. Thank you so much. Praise be to Allah. All right, family, unfortunately, we are coming close to the end of our show. We are going to have a part two, looks like, because there's great information being shared. It looks like a lot of the viewers are enjoying all the information that's being shared. But before we close out, I want to go ahead and mention a few things. Firstly, I want to mention, once again, going back to our CEO and founder of Rise Magazine, that is Student Regional Minister Abdul Sharrieff Muhammad. Without him, we would not have this platform and we would not have the publication of Rise Magazine. So we definitely, once more, we can never do it enough, but we definitely want to, again, acknowledge him for allowing us to be a part of this broadcast, to be a part of his vision, and to really come together collectively to show our unity, to share information. There's a lot of beautiful minds in the Nation of Islam, as you all heard from today, and we definitely want to promote that. And so once again, we thank you, Student Minister Sharrieff, for allowing us to have the Rise Magazine podcast and the publication of Rise Magazine, where people can share their truth and talk about their stories and just give information that needs to be shared. So we thank you for that. Also, I want to mention for our wonderful guests who we have on today, Student Minister Sister Zurifah Muhammad and Brother Student Minister Ilia Rashad Muhammad, I want to bring a few points about the two of them, and I'm going to read them off because it's important that we do this to show the intelligent minds, the great minds of our nation. And so I'll start off with Brother Ilia Rashad Muhammad and some of the points or some things that he does. And so he is a student minister serving on Minister Farrakhan's research team, NOI Research Group. He is the author of several books that defend the teachings of the NOI, including UFOs in the Nation of Islam and Exposing the War Against Islam, among others. He is a public educator, Memphis, urban gardener and beekeeper. Someone shouted that out earlier. He is a family man, husband and father, and a family slash community advocate. He is the producer of the documentary series Answered, which shows how the NOI literally answered the global UFO phenomena before the world even had questions about it. All praises due to Allah for that. Thank you, Brother Ilia Rashad, on behalf of Student Minister Sharrieff, for being with us today. I send you greetings on his behalf and a huge thank you and Ramadan Mubarak.
Ramadan Kareem, please extend the greetings back to Minister Sharrieff and all of the great and wonderful helpers in the southern region.
Yes, there will be. Praise be to Allah. Now let's go on to Student Minister Sister Zurifah Muhammad, because she's not going to mention it, so I'll definitely make sure that is mentioned here. And Athens is doing a great work. So for everyone who's watching, please show your support for Athens so that it can become a mosque. Student Minister Zurifah, she's a really beautiful person. She's doing a great job. And I'm going to mention some of the awards that Athens had won during Savior's Day, which is a big deal. All right, so let me go. Actually, Sister Zurifah, would you have the honors of sharing that with us, that information?
I'll let you do that.
Okay. Yes, well, I didn't want to miss anything out. So Athens received Secretary of the Year from the Southern Region from Brother Saad, and he actually signed it. They also received Certificate of Appreciation. They received, Athens Study Group received first place in the nation for community service. And it came out of the office of the student MGT captain. They got top final call newspaper, Salesman in Athens Award. Student Protocol of Athens is one of the 2 points of contact for our student regional protocol director. Let's see what else they have. Completed Secretary College 2.0, Secretary of the Year. Once again, I'll read that, in the Southern Region. That's a big deal for everyone watching. So we want to greatly say a huge congratulations and a round of applause. You can come off mute and give a round of applause for Athens for all of their wonderful work that they're doing.
I told you got a jewel in Athens.
Praise be to Allah. Anything that I missed, please let us know. You're working humbly, but we greatly appreciate everything that you're doing.
Praises be to Allah. Thank you, Sister Aziza. You know, it's not about my personal accomplishments. It's, for me, it's about the nation. You know, Brother Ilias is an educator. He's an educator. And here recently, the last 3 years, I've been working at a school, all boys. that was in the reason it's important to me is because most people don't know, because the lady who started the school is a woman, but she was inspired by Minister Rahman. He brought her out to the mosque. She heard the teachings. So she went back and started an all-boys school that was funded by the state charter. I went, even though my doctorate is in business, but I went to retire at the school. You know, I was just going to chill out, and, you know, but I got so involved when I saw the boys, grades 6 through 12, walking through with suits on, and they calling it Class A dress.
Look at
suits,
that.
Ties, belts, slacks, black shoes, and they call it Class A. And then on Fridays when they dress down, they call it Class B. So I was just excited just to see her take the teachings and come over and help our boys. So, you know, Athens is striving very hard to do just what the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan is doing in Chicago and what Brother Sharrieff strives very hard to do in Atlanta. We want to duplicate our headquarters. We want the MUI. You know, we want the classes for our boys and girls, the separate classes. So we love the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, and we love our local or regional minister, Brother Minister Abdul Sharrieff Muhammad. And we love the way that he loves the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. I mean, before Brother Sharrieff got here 19, 20 years ago, you know, it was not like this for me, you know. And a lot of us, Brother Ilia, I know you may not know, but we have over 1,000 families to come to Atlanta because Brother Sharrieff is here. And he does. And as we got a brother named Brother Barry that works with Brother Sharrieff, you know how he describes Brother Sharrieff is that Brother Sharrieff let everybody touch the ball. Man, he said it don't make no difference about who touched the ball. If you come to him with an idea, let's go with it. Let's see how it works. So, you know, and that's what stops us. The minister said in one of our study guides, envy is what's going to stop us if we don't get that under control. And Brother Sharrieff does not have that. So I know you want to come over to the Southern region, Brother Ilia. you know,
Brother don't be tempting me now.
Not like that.
Oh, don't be tempting me now.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. But you're going to come to Athens. I wouldn't let you stop in Atlanta for nothing. I'd have to send a shuttle after you, a bus, a train, and a plane. We would be trying to get you in Athens. But Brother Muthakir, from what I understand, is going to be at 15 Sunday.
That's right. That's right.
See, that's a beautiful thing.
Uh-huh.
So all praises be to Allah.
Praise
so you're going to be in Athens on... Oh, Brother Ilia Rashad is going to be in Athens on that Sunday, the 24th. You don't want to miss it. I mean, you want to come out. I got people that's telling me already they're going to stay over. You really want to be there on that Sunday. He got a beautiful message for us. Thank you, Sister Aziz. All praises be to Allah.
All right. Any closing words from either of our guests?
You know, I don't want to sound redundant, but again, I'm just super, super thankful, super grateful and excited about these opportunities, because with the invitation for us to come to Athens and present the screening of our documentary, it's not just watching a movie or giving a lecture, but what we're doing is doing things to help our nation win.
Yes.
You know, what Sister Zurifah is doing in Athens and elsewhere in the nation, it's for the nation to win. So I want to be a part of a winning team, and we can't go wrong as long as we're sticking with the game plan or the blueprint of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the Honorable Minister Farrakhan.
Yes,
that
sir.
In and of itself spells victory. So that's why I'm excited. Right.
Praise to Allah. Beautiful. Also, for our guests, if you can put your social media handle in the chat so that our tech team could put it up on the screen, that would be appreciated. All right, at this time, we want to let all of our viewers know to please support Rise Magazine. Actually, I'm holding a copy here, and this is one of our back issues. And this is the National Protocol Director, and his wife, Brother Rauf Muhammad and Sister Rafa Muhammad. And in it, we have an interview with Brother Ilia Rashad. I don't know if you remember that, for an interview we had done with you. And so for everyone who's watching, we don't have any more hard copies available. Those sold out. Like I mentioned, this is one of our back issues. But we do have digital copies available on our website, www.risemagazineco.com. Once again, that's www.risemagazineco.com. That's on the screen. And Sister Zurifah has been featured in our publication a few times, and we do plan on having her featured in talking about the great work that she's doing in Athens, along with the wonderful awards and certificates that they won during Savior's Day. So stay tuned for that, brothers and sisters, so that you can see what our nation is doing. Also want to mention, please show your support for Rise Magazine. Our Cash App is $RiseMagazine. Please give us any amount is appreciated so that we can keep this going, both the podcast and the publication. So once again, our Cash App is $RiseMagazine. If you have any questions, any comments, you can email us at risemagazineatlanta@gmail.com. That's also on the screen. Once again, that's risemagazineatlanta@gmail.com. At the bottom of the screen, you'll also see contact information for the wonderful guests that we had on our show today. With all that being said, family, we want to ask you to please show your support for all that we do here in the nation collectively. We want to make sure that we're showing unity. For those who watch the podcast, you often hear the ARC mentioned, that is located in Atlanta, Georgia. It has a variety of Black-owned businesses all under one roof, crafted by the mind of Student Regional Minister Abdul Sharrieff Muhammad. So please pay us a visit, give us a call. The address is 3638 Campbellton Road Southwest. That's Atlanta, Georgia. Once again, that's 3638 Campbellton Road Southwest. Brother Ilia Rashad has been there before. I remember meeting you for the first time there at the ARC. So once again, everyone who's watching, please make sure that you visit the ARC and make sure that you support all of the businesses. You can also give us a call at 404-963-1078. Once again, that's 404-963-1078. So we thank you all so much for watching another great episode of the Rise Magazine podcast. Please make sure you subscribe. With all that being said, we want to thank you all, and we leave you as we came before you in the greeting words of peace of As-Salaam Alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, ma'am.